Hey everybody, here we are at the office. As you see, the vacuums have become quite a mess. But first and foremost of the business, we have four new vacs in front of you there. If you can spot them out of this whole mess, we'll talk about them in a sec. So yeah, the collection here has kind of become a mess. I probably said in whatever the last video was I did here, if there was even one. Well, it might have been the video I was supposed to do, and it wouldn't upload. I've been having problems with videos uploading. But anyway, so yeah, I've been waiting to get about 95% of these vacs, everything except the really broken ones, which would be probably the Hoover Fusion and the Kenmore Power Center. Put all the vacs in my dad's friend's storage place where the other 50 storage vacs are. I consider these storage vacs. So yeah, anything I've gotten new, like the Oric, which is the newest vac that's been shown, and the four new ones, and all my extra little junk, like a little carpet cleaner, hand vac, and crap, that's all supposed to go to storage. I need to call him and see about that. So we have four new vacs, the two newest being these two... The two newest being these Regina Housekeepers. I bought these two days ago from the guy that has all the vacuums that I'm slowly weaning out his collection for him. I bought these in conjunction with picking up the three vacs that Stars 1976 wanted, three Bravos. Do a quick video on those before I start shipping them out to him where he can do his own videos with them. I figured I'd buy one or two vacs of my own to sweeten up the deal. Got the gray one for $10 and the blue one for $5. Blue one, the handle is busted. That's why it was parts machine handle is busted. For some dumb reason, I thought putting duct tape on it would make it look better. What I'm going to do whenever the next time I come here is super glue it on and then use some of that flexible bracket stuff and screw a bracket on each side and then one on the back. Hopefully that'll fix it. If not, I'm at a loss for words on that. And the gray housekeeper needs a bag, and they both need hoses. If you notice, the hose on, I think I'll take it off and show you, is a rather stubby little pink hose. Is it even in there? It's not even in there. So yeah, this little hose was what was on, or what he had for them. He didn't have any hoses on them. And he's like, well, that doesn't look like the right hose. I said, yeah, that must have came off that Housekeeper 2000. And he's like, well, even that hose is longer. Or at least I said that. He was confused all around. I said, you know what probably happened? Because I remember him saying he scrapped one of those 2000s before, 2000, 3000s, trying to fix the one he's got with that fancy belt clutch thing. So this was probably the lower intake hose from the brush roll to the wand that he, for some reason, stuck on these, which didn't have hoses, because these hoses were obviously supposed to be light blue and light gray. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the ends off of this hose for the gray one, because the ends work fine for attaching each end. I'm going to get some probably black shop vac hose, a regular like 1 1/4 vacuum hose, and do that, and then I'll have to figure out something for attaching a hose on this one. So for now it's gonna sit pretty on there. So that's what's up with that. And they both need bags now. The blue one had a bag in it, and I tried taking it out to put it in the gray one, because of course I can't run the blue one because the handle's busted, and the bag literally fell apart as I was taking it out. So I guess they both need bags now, and the blue one needs a belt. I was debating on what vacs to buy from him. I had been thinking about it for a while. I wanted to buy a carpet machine, either one of the little short, stubby, round ones, or a power steamer. But a couple weeks back, I went to the scrapyard to scrap a couple small things to get them out of my way, and I found that power steamer to your left. So I'm like, well, getting a third power steamer or carpet machine is probably out of the question. Now that I got this one, I'll talk about that, of course. And I was thinking about his Hoover Commercial Elite, but that thing needed a fan, belt, bag, cord, probably a motor mount, because those always bust when the fan goes. And I'm like, I don't want to be bothering with that. I'm not going to buy a vacuum that I got to put $30 into. He was giving it to me. Yeah, sure, fine, I'll do it. And I really wanted his parts a Bravo World Vac, but the piece that's missing, which would be the automatic door converter thing for the hose to the floor, it's missing it. And chances are nobody will ever come across one of those unless somewhere somebody's scrapping one of those machines and has that, which the chances are slim. So that was probably out of the question. And the only other parts machines he had were a broom vac, don't need another one of those, plus it needs a fan. A Dirt Devil light, needed a fan, don't need another one of those. Trying to think what else parts machines he had. The Housekeeper 2000, he wasn't quite ready to sell that, nor did I want another one. And that was basically it for the parts machines. Everything else would probably be like $20 a piece, which I didn't want. Nor do I like any of the F&G machines he had. Would consider one of the twin fan singers, but that's definitely out of my needs for right now on spending money. So my last one that I was definitely considering was the Grey Regina. I'm like, maybe I'll just get this one. I did consider his other Elite 350, but I'm like, I don't need two Elite 350s. I mean, I already got a bunch of Elites, and the Elite 350 and the 500 are basically the same thing, so I don't need another one. So yeah, I first settled on the gray one, and I'm like, well, you know what, maybe I'll get the blue one instead, because the blue one will probably be cheaper because it's broken more. And then I'm like, hey, well, you know what, why don't we just make one big sweet deal here? I'll buy Josh's three Eurekas, and I'll buy these two Reginas. And he's like, oh, okay, it's fine with me. So he got $70 in his pocket, and or something like that. And I got two contrasting Reginas, because I thought that was rather interesting. After I thought about it, that I got the, even though Regina is like the shittiest, probably the shittiest vacuum ever made, quality wise in every way. There's like a hierarchy of quality within Regina, if that's even possible, because they're like lowest quality to begin with. For example, the gray one is probably the most high optioned Regina they had. Wide path, 8.4 amp motor, 5 height levels, headlight, 2 speed, what else does it say? Check bag indicator, 14 pounds, blah blah blah. Whereas this one's very basic, no, apparently a bumper's an amenity. There's no bumper, unless it's supposed to. Nope. Maybe. Might be supposed to have a bumper. That one's a 6 amp, 1 speed, no headlight, just very basic. So I thought that was interesting. You got the higher end Regina and the lower end Regina. So I thought that was a nice thing. And for $15, I can't really complain. I'm not going to have to put much money into it besides a pack of bags. But now, if I had to buy a pack of bags for just one machine, I wouldn't be too happy about that. Like, I had to get bags for that the Housekeeper 3000. Wasn't too happy about buying a pack of bags. It only fits one machine that I rarely use. Same with, what's another machine? When I had to buy a bag, Eureka AAAs, I rarely use the machine that takes them, but I had to buy them because I needed a bag. Whereas Hoover Type A and Eureka Type U, I probably go through those things the most because they're in the most of my machines. So anyway, so there's the two Reginas. I will, the gray one obviously won't be picking anything up because there's no suction hose, but I can, of course, run it because the belt works and everything's cool with that. And the blue one, no point in running that until I modify the handle. Enough of my ramblings on that. Now for the, is it in there? Yep. Now for the Bissell Powersteamer. I said I was at the scrapyard. This was probably at least a month ago, I want to say. A couple of weeks is a month. And I was scrapping some stuff. And I saw the wand, or no, I saw the top of the hose sticking out, top of the hose up there. Saw that sticking out of a pile of junk. And I'm like, oh, that's probably to an old shop vac, or that might be to a carpet steamer. And sure enough, I followed it, and it went to the wand, which is attached. And I'm like, oh, cool. I could always use one of those wands and crap. And I grabbed that, and it had the solution hose attached to it. And I followed the 50 feet of solution hose and found the top of the machine. And under another pile, I found the bottom of the machine. I'm like, oh, cool. So I grabbed that up. And compared to all my other ones, or how many do I have? The carpet machine and the power steamer. Compared to my other two, this one at least has one retaining clip on it, the clips that hold the thing together. And compared to my other power steamer, this is a one speed. I don't know why you'd ever need two speeds with something like that. So yeah, I also thought it was strange that the cord was missing. Must have been one scrapper came by and took the cord, and another scrapper thought he could get money for the machine and took the machine. So it doesn't have a cord. I haven't tested it yet. I'm going to assume it works. Somebody just threw it out because they got tired of the So 1990 machine. So this will sit here for a while until I deal with taking the thing apart. Because I remember I had to take mine apart, my other one apart, to put a cord on it. That was a pain in the ass. So not a top priority right now. And plus, I keep forgetting to bring a test cord to attach to it when I take it apart. So it's not going to happen. So there's that second power steamer to the family. Then over here, to your left a little more, is a Hoover Widepath. Picked that up about, you might have got that before the power steamer, a couple days before the power steamer. I had to come home to pick up some tools to go back to a site my friend was working at so I could do a tune-up on his van for him. And lucky as I was driving down the street adjacent to mine, and there was sitting this Hoover on the curb on trash day, or trash put-out day, and it still had the cord attached to it. And luckily, the fan got jammed by a nice large nut and didn't break it. It just jammed in there, just like a little toy that got jammed in my runabout years back. It jammed in there and just it froze the motor until it gets unjammed. So luckily, they didn't burn it out or anything trying to run it. They realized they jammed it, didn't care to figure out how to take it apart or didn't know how to, and tossed it. Looks like they were probably using it in the garage or something because there's a bunch of cobwebs and crap on the underside, so that would make sense. That's how a nut got in there. Missing the attachment door and the dusting brush, no big deal. I'm just happy it has a cord and a hose, or it has to have the hose. It doesn't come off unless you take the machine apart. So once I took the nut out of there, thing ran great. Bag's half decent in it, belt's pretty much shot. Again, doesn't really matter because it's not getting used for practical purposes. So that's all the updates on the new VAX. And as I said, it's a big mess in here. Only thing that's been added are the two dirt double featherlight bagelses for my house that I tossed out to make room for my new runabout and make a little extra space in there in my basement, which I did. And of course, I tossed the orc here at about the same time. And over here, might as well show you, a bunch of my junk, the deck and extra deck for my riding mower, my friend's power washer, project lawnmower, my cart, blah, blah, blah. The two dirt devils with the funky motor issues, they run fine but are extremely loud. Their bases and the base for the white Westinghouse, which has no motor. My Grand Rapids sweeper, extra Kenmore power nozzle, a bunch of tires, fans, organ, office junk. Anyway, so that all said, do a little running here of the Regina, and then we'll run the... Oh, I'm getting a phone call. 1 second. Nope, can't answer that. It's one person I never answer the phone for. So, yeah, we'll run the Regina now. Course, which comes with Regina's many failures, is the placement of the power switch is down here. So like if you're using the vacuum, you gotta pretty much stand this thing up to see the switch, to see where you're switching it. And it's very you gotta be very careful when you move it, because as you probably saw a very quick glimpse of when I went to shut it off from low, it ended up on high. And at least it came with a crevice tool. Don't know what other tools it was supposed to come with. Looks like a wand or two. And there was supposed to be, I don't know if you can see it, like right down here, there was supposed to be, I'm assuming what was, a handle release, and it was busted, so I just yanked it out because it was stopping me from putting the cover on correctly, which, again, shows how cheap, angle it down a bit, shows how cheap Regina's are, is that it's actually the base of the thing, the bottom part and the top part are what hold the machine together. There's no motor brackets or anything that hold it to the base. It's just the base holds it around a molded piece of the motor casing, which is a bunch of junk. Same thing with the handle release on the other Regina. I didn't take it out because the little arm that holds it in place wasn't broken, but it serves no purpose. And now we'll run the wide path real quick. Now this is, of course, basically, it is the exact same thing as my Breathe Easy and is the bagged version of the twin chamber. Same base, motor, and everything. Smell that belt. Alrighty. So, hope you enjoyed the running of two of the four newest vacuums. And little updates here on the collection in the office. Of course, I'm always looking forward to more vacuums. And when I get them, I'll try to put the videos up.